Hello scientific people, how are you today? Today we are going to discuss about the working of an hand pump in three easy steps. So we'll discuss about the parts and then we will see the role of atmospheric pressure in working of the hand pump. So let's begin with the parts of the hand pump. Here we have the different parts shown over, and this part is called the handle. Handle can go up and down. This is piston. This is nozzle. These are called valves. This is valve A. This is valve B. This part is the lower chamber. This part, white part, is upper chamber. Now what happens is the length of the upper and lower chamber, this is right now the upper chamber's length and this is the lower chamber's length. So the lower chamber starts from here, ends up over here, and the upper chamber starts from here, finishes over here. So if the handle goes down, the piston goes up. The movement of the handle and piston are opposite, and when the piston goes up, the upper chamber becomes smaller and the lower chamber becomes bigger, correct? So these are the different parts. Now the valves also, if one of the valves stays closed, then the other opens and vice versa. So in part A, what happens is the piston has to be brought up and the handle goes down. So if the handle goes down, then so we are supposed to exert the force like this, so the handle will go down. Piston goes up, due to which, assume no water over here. Right now there is no water. So this goes down, piston goes up, then inside there is air. Now the air pressure inside and the air pressure outside, this is the air pressure, are same. Here also the air is there and here also air is there. But if you bring this up, then the volume increases. So you can apply the Boyle's law over here. The volume inside the lower chamber increases, so the air pressure decreases, due to which this pressure becomes more. So when this pressure becomes more, so this water is being pushed in. So this water exerts pressure on valve B. So this valve B opens and finally the water starts filling up in the lower compartment. At that time, this valve A stays closed and finally the water is sucked into the lower chamber, right? In part 2, what happens is we are supposed to exert opposite force on the handle. So the handle goes up, so you are supposed to push the handle like this. Piston goes down. Now it exerts pressure on the water which is filled in the lower chamber. Now water has its own weight, so weight is always in the downward direction. So due to this weight, this valve B closes. So now the water is incompressible, water cannot go down. So if this piston pushes the water down, the water also pushes the piston in the upward direction, because water can't be compressed. Due to this upward pressure by water on the valve A, it opens and slowly the water starts transferring from lower chamber to the upper chamber. This is what happens in part 2. So in part 2, the handle goes up, piston goes down, valve A opens and B closes, right? And in the last and final part, due to the weight of the water in the upper chamber, this is the weight direction, the valve A closes. Now when valve A closes, again the water starts rising up and it again starts filling up in this compartment. And when this arrangement is brought above, just above the nozzle, this water now starts flowing out, correct? And then the entire cycle keeps on repeating again and again. So in part 3, again, why the water starts filling up over here is because when this goes up, again the volume of this compartment increases. So when volume increases, the pressure decreases, and when this pressure decreases, then again the air pressure comparatively becomes more and it pushes the water up. So again the water starts filling over here. Now let us see all these three in a slide and end up our discussion. This is step one. Handle goes down, piston goes up. So the at this particular chamber, that is the lower chamber, volume increases, the air pressure inside decreases. So the air pressure over here is comparatively more, pushes the water down, water in turns pushes this up, B opens, A stays closed, and water eventually starts gathering over here. Now the handle is to be pushed up, piston goes down, liquid is incompressible. So due to this weight of the liquid, weight is in the downward direction, valve B closes, liquid is incompressible, and we are pushing this piston down. So liquid is being exerted by the lower pressure. So the liquid also presses or applies the pressure in the upward direction. And due to this pressure, the valve A opens and the liquid or the water goes up in the upper chamber. Now finally, again, we are supposed to bring this piston up by pushing the handle down. You exert the force like this, handle goes down, piston moves up. So whatever water that was collected in the upper chamber, its weight is going to shut down this valve. And again, since this entire arrangement is going up, so the water will flow out of the nozzle like this. And again, the volume in this compartment increases, pressure decreases. So the atmospheric pressure will again push the liquid or the water down. So the water will rise up. Due to its pressure, the valve B opens, and again this cycle continues. So hopefully guys, you have enjoyed my explanation, and if you have any doubts, please do comment in the comment section. Thank you for watching the video.